Welcome to Trinity University. My name is Daniel Piri. I'll be taking you into the course entitled Introduction to Political Education and Public Administration. This falls under the School of Health Sciences, under the program of Public Health. The course code for the one I'm taking you is the course code is PHT114. The aim of the course is to introduce you students to basic fundamentals of political education and public administration. This is fundamental to you as a student so that you will be able to understand the importance of politics and administration as you work as public workers in the government. You know, you might be able to wonder, you might be able to ask, why should public health students learn political education and public administration? The importance is so immense in the sense that students of public health may work in public departments under the government. And the government is purely controlled by politicians. So it is important that you are aware of how the political system is in the government and the country as a whole. It is very important and it is very necessary that each one of you and those people in civil service are aware of how they should go about with the government and with the public administration. The students, as you are aware, should be able to define and understand and explain other things in terms of parliament, in terms of the executive, the judiciary, so that they know their parameters as they are working as health workers. They should also be able to understand and be able to know the existing laws pertaining to public health. Minus that, it will be very difficult for you students to appreciate the importance of public health. As public health, you deal with various institutions, and those institutions are at least in tandem with the government. So it is important to also understand and know what is actually happening. That is why it is very important, because you must also understand the election processes which are taking place in the country, so that you are able to know the power of people voting. They might vote for a different political party which will bring in laws which will be affecting the public health, or they might bring in something which they will be able to change the situation. That's why it is important you understand. And sometimes when you are doing some work, some politicians might want to ask you to do certain things which are not in tandem with your career or with your profession as a public health worker. So that's why it is important, so that you know your parameters, you know your limits, you know where you're supposed to be able to understand the situation. It is very imperative that you understand the policies of the government as you do your work. Minus that, it becomes difficult to understand, and you should be able to know the institutions you are working for, what are the political connotations and political attachments, so that you are able to do that. You should always remember that public health falls under the Ministry of Health, and the Minister of Health is headed by a minister who is a political appointee. There are certain things they might be able to do which might be able to affect your work. As long as you don't understand the politics, you will be able to find it difficult. But when you understand the politics, you know how they operate, it will be easy for you to go about it and be able to work accordingly. The other thing that you need to understand is that there is the understanding of public administration. And you must be able to understand that public administration is very important in any given organization. As you are a public health worker, you should be able to understand and make differences or differentiate between public administration and the private administration and management. When you are working in a public health, you are dealing with the public. It's not a private thing per se. Though there will be some people who will be working in private companies, they will be dealing with the private management and private administration, you are also supposed to understand what private administration and public administration mean. You should be able to know that there is evolution in public administration and in private administration. You need to appreciate this fact so that you are able to be in tandem with your profession and you understand and you are able to execute your duties professionally. It is also important that you look at public administration is a science. When you look at public administration, it is a science and an art. When you are performing, you should be able to know that there's something that you need to perfect and you need to be able to work extra well. The other thing that you need to understand why this course is important in public health is that you need to understand the theories and approaches in the study of organization and management. These theories will help you to go about. You need to be able to understand and be able to define, determine, and understand the limits of each given theory. You know, you are supposed to be able to define the classical, bureaucratic, and the scientific management theories. All those, you should be able to know them. And once you know those, you'll be able to appreciate the importance. And you should be able to show the differences between the bureaucratic. You should be able to show the difference between the scientific and management so that you are able to appreciate the weaknesses of each theory. And when you are doing that, you'll be able to work well in your profession as a health public worker. You must also be able to understand, to point out critically the issues that are with in respect with the respective theories. You must also know that there is what we call Marxism and non-Marxism. These will help you to understand because some are purely pro-workers and some are purely pro-capitalists. So you need to understand all these things so that they help you to get to know the things. It's not only that, you also need to understand the dynamics in administration. When you understand the dynamics in administration, you'll be able to appreciate. This course will introduce you to leadership. The term leadership may mean a lot of things, and no single author may be able to explain or define leadership as a complete one, or as the last definition per se. You know, when you define the leadership, you'll be able to find that leadership is in many aspects. There's leadership at home, there's leadership at your place of work, there's leadership in private companies, there's leadership in public offices. You need to give those understandings as a public health worker. You must be able to know that there are different types of leadership that exist in any given organization and in any given society. We need to identify and discuss different qualities that leaders may have so that you may be able to know when you are a public worker. You should be able to know that sometimes you are not the overall. You are not the overall person who is responsible for running the organization. You might be a subordinate. And being a subordinate, sometimes there is that subordinate and supervisor challenge that borders on leadership. If there's good leadership on both you and the supervisor and the worker, or you are the supervisor and your subordinate, you find that things will go well. And as a public health worker, these are very important for you to understand. You need to know also the behavioral changes in people so that you understand their leadership mode, their leadership ways of doing things, and then things will be able, so that you must be able to know how the theories of maybe X and Y interact and how they differ, so that you may be able to do the rightful thing. You need to appreciate the aspect that if you know the principles in leadership, there is the Pareto, there is the Peter principles, you should be able to accept and be able to do the rightful thing.